let us see the properties of multiplication of integer. First is that it is closed under multiplication. That is, whenever you multiply two integers, you will get always an integer. Take some other example. Like minus 15 into minus 23, and minus minus is what? Plus, and 23 into 15. So whatever you get, the value will be integer only. So 5 3 is 15, 1 1 5, and 23. 5 4 3 4 5. So the values, whichever is this, that integers are closed under multiplication. That means A and B, if they are integers, for all values, all those values for A and B, the result will always be an integer. Commutativity of multiplication. Commutativity means commutation, means going from one place to another. So if you take 3 into minus 4, or you take minus 4 into 3, you just commute minus 4 here and 3 here. Minus 4 into 3 will always give you minus 12 and minus 12. So what we infer, or what our inference would be, is that 3 into minus 4 or 4 minus 4 into 3 will always give you minus 12. We can take any other example, like minus 17 into 0, it is going to give you 0. 0 into minus 17, it will give you 0. So every time you get 0, that is again an integer. So multiplication is commutative for integer. You do A into B or you do B into A, the result would be same. Then multiplication by 0. Whenever you multiply any value, any integer with 0, it will always give you 0. You multiply 0 with that number or that number with 0, you will always get a 0. Right? We know that whole number is multiplied by 0, it will give you 0. This is true with the integers also. Multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity means, you know, we have seen that 0 is the additive identity. Means if you add any integer with 0, you will get that value again back. How to get the value back? Minus 3 into 1, because we want some identity or some value which gives you the same result in multiplication. That only could be 1. So you multiply any value with 1, any value with 1 or value with 1, you will always get the same value. Minus 5 into 1 is minus 5. So A into 1 or 1 into A is going to give you 0. 1 is the multiplicative identity, 0 was the additive identity. So you multiply 1 with any of these, you get the same value. How about multiplying minus 1? Say, if you multiply A with minus 1, you get what? You get minus A. Or rather, you multiply A with minus 1. Again, you get minus A. So the additive inverse of an integer would be minus A. Any A, the additive inverse would be minus A. Associativity of multiplication. Multiplication associativity means if we have three values. Let us multiply these two and then multiply it with 5. Or you can take these two first and then multiply it by 3. How you do it? You use the square brackets or the brackets. So minus 3 into minus 2 is 3 into 2 is 6, minus minus is plus. It will be 6. 6 into 5 is 30. This is 30. Then minus 2 into 5, because we are doing this first. Minus 2 into 5, minus minus is minus, plus is minus. 5 into 10 is 5 into 2 is 10. Minus 3 into minus 10, minus minus is plus. So it again gives you 30. From this discussion, we observe, and this is true for this also, we observe that multiplication or grouping of integer affect the product of integer? No. Because if you multiply A and B and result with C, or you multiply B into C, the result with A, the result is going to be same. So the product of three integers, how can you say? Because the product or multiplication does not depend on the grouping of integers. That is why we are calling it as a associative property, which holds for multiplication of integers. Distributive property. This is a very important property. This you need to understand, that I have 16 and I want to multiply it with 12. I write 16 and 12 as 10 into 10 plus 2. What we can do is, distribution means I multiply this with 10, 16 into 10, then there is a plus sign, then I multiply 16 with 2. this give me 160, this give me 32. The result will be 192. If I multiply directly 16 into 12, let us see what happens. This is 32, this is 16. So it again gives me 192. So in both the cases, this holds. So distributive property holds for integers. We can take one more example. Let us take this. Minus 4 into minus 2 plus 7. So what we are going to do here is, first we will do it by the way we are doing it. Was 7 minus 2. Minus 2 plus 7 is 7 minus 2 only. So 7 minus 2 is 5. 5 multiplied by minus 4 is minus 20. Minus n plus gives minus. How about distributing it? First we will multiply minus 4 with minus 2. Then we add the result with minus 4 into 7 like this. Minus 4 into minus 2, then minus 4 into 7. Minus 4 into minus 2 is what? 8. 4 to the 8, minus minus is plus. Minus minus is minus and 7 4 is 28. So minus 28. 8 minus 28 is what? Minus 20. So here also minus 20. Here also minus 20. So this distributive hold. Again, this is the similar example. So what we can derive or what we can say here is A into B plus C can be written as A into B plus A into C. This is the distributive property. We can try a few more examples. Let us try it for the subtraction. Whether the multiplication is distributive over subtraction or not. So let us take this example. Minus 5 into minus 4 minus of minus 6. So let us do it by the way we are doing it right now. Minus 4 minus of minus 6, that is plus 6. This is going to give you minus 2. This is going to give you 2, sorry. 2 into minus 5 is? 2 into minus 5 is what? Plus minus is minus 5, 2 is 10. So it gives you minus 10. Let us distribute it. Minus 4 into minus 4, minus 5 into minus 4 first. Then we subtract it with minus 5 into minus 6. This gives you 20 because minus minus plus. This gives you 30 plus, means in addition. So 20 minus 30 is what? Minus 10. Again minus 10. So now we again say that the distributive property holds for the subtraction as well. So A into B minus C can be written as A into B minus A into C. So you can verify this also. You can take any example. How to make multiplication easier? Because we have just learned about the property. And these properties are very beneficial and very handy when it comes to computation. Let us see how. When you want to multiply minus 25 with 37 with 4, you will multiply minus 27 with 37, you get minus 2925. Then you multiply this result with 4, you get minus 3700. How can we make this multiplication easier? See, this minus 25 and 4 you can first take, this is going to be 100, right? Minus 100. This is minus 100. Now you know when you multiply anything with 100 or any, 00 terms, you just have to add 0. So minus 3700. This is how you actually made this look simpler. If you multiply this, it would be, somewhat time consuming rather than this. So this is the trick. So we can use these commutativity, associativity and distributivity to make our multiplication easier. How? If you want to multiply 16 into 12, we have already seen this. Why not to write 12 as 10 plus 2? Multiply 16 with 10, this will be 160. Multiply 16 with 2, this is quite easy, 32. So 16 into 10, 32, you just add 192. Let us take one more example like this. Minus 35 into minus 98. Let us write 90 as 8 as 100 minus 2, or you can say because this is minus, we'll write minus 100 plus 2. So this is minus 100 plus 2, and let us distribute it. Minus 35 into minus 100, and then minus 35 into plus 2. So minus 35 into minus 100, this is going to be plus 3500. And 35 into 2 is 70, minus 70. So 3500 minus 70 is 3430. If you take this example is quite, you can do it by various method. I'm just giving you an example, one method. Take 52 outside. Okay, what is inside? Minus 8. And here 2. But because here is minus, we'll keep minus here. Minus 8 into minus 2 is minus 10. You multiply 52 with minus 10, you get minus 520. This is the result. So you have made your computation easier. You can try a few more. We have to find each of the following products like minus 18 into minus 10 into minus into 9. What you can do here is first multiply 18 with 10. It will be 180. 180 minus 9 is quite easy, 1620. You can take one more example like this. Here, what you can do here is minus minus plus minus minus plus. So the answer would be minus. You just have to multiply the numbers out only. So first multiply 5 into 1, that is going to be 5. Multiply this 6 with 4, 24. 24 into 5 is 120. You have to verify this. So first do this. 13 minus 3 is 10. 10 into minus 30 is minus 300. And this is the distribution. Minus 30 into 13 is what? This is going to give you minus 390. And 30 into 3 minus of, that is 90. 90 minus, minus 390 plus 90 is minus 300. So this holds. This gives you the distributive property example. Now, in a class test containing 15 questions, so there are 15 questions in all, 4 marks are given for every correct answer and minus 2 are subtracted, or minus 2, 2 is deducted for every incorrect answer. The first part is Gurpreet attempts all the questions but only 9 of her answers are correct. What is her total score? So what she has attempted all questions but 9 are correct. So for correct, how many she should get? 9 into 4. So 9 4 is 36. But the rest means she has attempted all the questions. Rest means 15 minus 9. Rest is what? 15 in all, she attempted 9. Or you say 9 is correct. She attempted all. So the with the values which are not correct or incorrect are 6. 6. But how much penalty is there for the negative marking is there for the wrong answer? Minus 2. So you just have to multiply 6 into minus 2. This will give you minus 12. And now you can just say that the total score would be 36 plus minus 12. That is 24 she got. One of her friends get only 5 answers correct. So 5 answer correct means 10 incorrect. 15 minus 5. So 5 is correct. So she get 5 correct. That means 5 into 4. Incorrect means 10 into minus 2. You just have to add this. So 5 4 is 20 and then 10 into minus 2, that is minus 20. 20 plus of minus 20 is 0. So she gets 0. Suppose we represent the distance above the ground by a positive integer and the below the ground by a negative integer. This is above ground, below ground. This is plus, this is minus. An elevator descends into a mine shaft at a rate of 5 meter per minute. So it is going down. So we'll take 5 meter per minute as minus, minus 5, the distance will be minus 5. What will be the position after 1 hour? Okay, since the elevator is going down, so the distance would be negative integer. So the change in position is what? Minus 5 meter per minute. So in 1 minute, this is minus 5 meter. So in 60 minute, it will be minus 5 into 50, that is minus 300 meter, 300 below the ground. How about if it begins to descend at 15 meter above the ground? What will be its position after 45 minutes? So what we are going to do here is, in 45 minutes, how much it travels? We know that minus 5 is traveled at 1 minute. In 45 minutes, it will be minus 5 into 45, that is minus 225. But this minus 225 is from here to here. 15 has to be added because it started with 15. So we added minus 225 with 15. This is the distance it went below the ground level, minus 210.